Welcome to America's Got Talent. And who are you?
My name is Cam Bertrand. I'm a stand-up comedian from Tampa, Florida.
But you don't sound like you're from Tampa, Florida.
My accent's all over the place. Through the set, you'll hear it fluctuate. It's weird. Public school and, I don't know, I'm weird.
Welcome to the club.
Yeah, we did it.
So you said you're a stand-up comedian.
Yes, I am.
Yes.
I've been doing stand-up for about 8 years now.
And how did you get into that?
When I was a kid, I would stay up far past my bedtime, and I would watch more comedy than a kid probably should. It's actually how I first saw Howie. Yeah.
Also, that was a long, long time ago.
Cam, good luck to you.
Thank you. I actually just turned 27. I celebrated my birthday a couple weeks ago. Yeah, it's weird turning 27 because I feel like I'm getting older, but my face isn't. Yeah, it's strange. Like, it's tough having a baby face, you know, because, like, all I wanted to do for my birthday was to celebrate by getting a nice bottle of wine, you know, like an adult. But when I went to the store, I picked out the bottle I wanted. I went to the counter. I put it on the counter, as you do for purchases, right? And the lady looked at me. She looked at the bottle. She looked back at me, and she went, ha! No! That was it. That was the whole transaction. That's not protocol. You don't just get to go, no! Right? I was upset. I wasn't mad that she thought I was underage. I get it. I look 17 at best. I wasn't mad she thought I was young. But I was upset that she thought an underage person would be buying wine. Right? Like, I don't understand. In what world do you live in, Rebecca, where some 17-year-old dude is showing up to this house party like, y'all not gonna believe this. I got Pinot Grigio! Yeah, got that Grigio! Let's do shots of Chardonnay. Let's start a book club! Yeah. It's never happened, right? You don't know a 17-year-old that owns a corkscrew. That's weird, all right? Not one time in your entire life can you tell me a time where you've seen a 17-year-old dude be like, This Merlot pairs so well with the Doritos Locos Taco.
Oh, that's good.
It is just something about Zinfandels in a Hot Pocket that is to die for. I think there's two things alcohol-wise we should stop IDing for altogether, right? Wine and bourbon. Yeah, because no matter how old you are, if you're drinking them, you've earned it. Think about it. If you're drinking wine, clearly you have a lot of emotions and you're going through some things. And if you're drinking bourbon, you have no emotions. You've been through some things. Thank you, guys. It's been my time.
What is your name?
Kristal Powell.
And how old are you?
Woo! 46.
We want to know what you're here to do.
I am here to tell the funny, to bring some laughter to the world.
How is a comedian?
Getting constructive criticism from the god. Sorry.
Where are you from?
I am from Texas.
And you live in Texas?
No, I live here in Los Angeles now. I do comedy part-time, and I still have a marketing gig as well.
Have you had like a horrific gig that you still remember?
I got booed once. When I left, they were like, you cute though, you got cute shoes, girlfriend.
Oh my
Anytime
God.
Somebody starts talking about your shoes instead of your set, that's when you know you tank.
Why AGT?
Because this is the biggest stage in the world, and the world gets to see my talent, and this is a career changer for me. This is it.
Okay, so we're ready for you.
All right, let's
ahead,
do it.
Make us laugh.
All right, let's do it. You all need different types of friends. See me, I got my Caucasian friends. You know Becky and them with the good hair. I got Keisha and them, coo-coo! And for those that are culturally challenged, Keisha 9 times out of 10 is a black girl. But see, unfortunate for me, my husband got caught cheating, but my girlfriends were there to see him. So when Becky called me, bring, bring, hello, Kristal. She said, are you sitting down?
Do I need to be?
She says, I just saw your husband with a lady we've never seen before. I've never seen her in the carpool lane. She's not even in Zumba. But when he gets home, ask him who this strange woman was. It was probably that Boston. The problem with that is Keisha synced him too. So Keisha called me, and when Keisha called me, her ringtone is totally different. Keisha was like, sis, is your husband home? I was like, no. She said, I know he not, because he right downtown Pasadena with a woman at a restaurant. I see him. Didn't you say he was laid off? Because she got an appetizer, entree, and dessert. Wait a minute. I mean, she cute and all. She ain't got nothing on you. You the real MVP. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. They leaving. Her license plate is 776-298. You need different friends. Yeah. It's a must. Another way I can show you, the Star Spangled Banner. When Becky sings the Star Spangled Banner, oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light? That's the way it's supposed to go. But how do you think that same song goes when Keisha sings it? Turn my mic up, turn my mic up. Me, 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 me. Oh, oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light? What's so proudly we hailed? That's my time, guys.
Good evening, young man. Thank you. Thank you very much.
You're welcome. What's your name?
Marty Ross.
And where are you from?
Santa Clarita, California.
Okay. What do you do for a living?
What did I do?
Okay.
I was a salesman in the clothing industry for almost 50 years.
And what is it that you're going to do?
Stand-up comedy. Yeah.
Is this something you always wanted to do and then...
Yeah.
Why didn't you start earlier?
Here's the thing. I didn't know I could do this. I didn't know I can stand in front of these many people and do what I do.
Yeah. Are you married?
I have 3 ex-wives.
That's a routine.
Yeah, right. So that means I need $1 million, like, as soon as possible.
What would winning mean to you?
Are you kidding me? First of all, winning at any age is incredible.
Yeah, and your age is?
How old are you?
80.
What?
You're 80?
I'm 80.
Oh, my God.
80. It would mean everything to me, because just the dream to be able to do this show with so many talented people is incredible.
Good answer. Yeah. Wow.
So dazzle us with your humor, and I hope we all get to witness your dream come true.
Thank you very much.
Here we go.
So I turned 80 a few months ago, and people are saying the weirdest things to me, like, oh, you're 80? You're almost dead. Are you afraid? I'm like, no, I'm not afraid. My mother made it to 101. And if you want to know the family secret, we don't die. No, we keep shrinking till we just disappear. So I went to visit my mother in the nursing home. You know the problem when you go to a nursing home and you look like me? Yeah, they wouldn't let me out. The only reason I'm here tonight is I had to get a night pass from the front desk. The first thing I found out when I get old is that young people hate old people.
Oh,
is that right?
No.
Really? Did you ever drive behind an old person?
Yes.
Does this look familiar?
Yes.
Yeah. The worst thing I'm experiencing now at 80 is that my hearing has gotten awful. I'm talking to this woman the other day, and she tells me she has a peanut allergy. Right, I misheard the word. I said, what happens? She said, I start choking and gagging. I said, what did your doctor say? She said, my doctor said I have to build up a tolerance. So naturally, I said, well, then I'm your man. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Ago, actually. Here, lots changed since, well, not that much has changed, but I'm still not married, still no kids. I did become an uncle for the fifth time. But don't applaud that. Who cares about being an uncle? Uncles don't do anything. Have you been to the bookstore? There's a whole section on parenting. There's no uncle books. Nobody ever wrote, like, what to expect when your sister's expecting. And a lot of magazines about parenting. There's no Uncle Weekly magazine. What would an article be in that magazine? Is your nephew out of control with drugs and alcohol? Well, since it's not your problem, here's some weekend getaway ideas. Can't believe 5 years since I've been here before. 30 years since I graduated high school. I was just at my reunion. You know, Facebook has ruined the high school reunion as we know it. You used to go to a high school reunion. It was fascinating because you hadn't seen people in years. It was fun to see what happened to everyone. I went to mine. I see everybody on Facebook. I could have stayed home. I'm going up to people like, oh my God, you haven't changed a bit since that new profile pic you posted last night.
Come on. That's funny.
I think dating is a lot easier now. We got text messaging now. When I first started trying to date, you had to call a girl up and have what's known as a conversation. Calling girls up, I'd be shaking like a leaf. I'm like, maybe we can have coffee or something. But texting is easy. I'm like a different person. I'm like, yo, baby girl, what you doing with your fine self? Why don't you shake that booty on over here? Then she gets to my apartment. I'm like, girl, you looking fine tonight. She's like, I'm standing right here. Why are you still texting me? That happened to me.
No!
What?
Uh-oh.
Keep going.
No, it happened to me recently. Simon, I got a joke for you. You should have waited. You jumped the gun on this one, because you're going to love this next bit.
You're going to love
By accident, I texted my cousin Sheila, come over, I'm horny.
Right.
But as soon as I realized what I did, I apologized. I said, oh my God, cousin Sheila, I'm so sorry. That was actually meant for somebody else, so sorry you came all the way over here.
My name is Kara with a K.
And where are you from? Kara with a K.
I'm originally from Texas. Yeehaw. I live here in Hollywood now.
Kara, how old are you?
Well, I'm technically 37. I could play 27, I think, with good lighting. thank you, Lord.
So why do you think you're not had the break you think you've needed?
I've been waiting for you, baby. You make dreams happen. Everything he touches turns to gold. Simon, honey, I need you to put your hands all over my dreams.
It's supposed to be the other way around, Kara. You're supposed to make our dreams come true.
Buckle up, put her in neutral, and enjoy the ride, okay? Because
I didn't say put her in neutral.
You know, just sit back, relax, you know.
Okay, so I'm in first gear right now. What do I do?
Oh, okay, is this an English thing? Okay, okay, darling. What you got to do, I know that was a bad accent, don't kill me, but you basically just do this.
Yep.
Lean her back. Just like maybe release a button off the notch of your belt.
I got it.
Love you, Howie.
I love you too.
Love you. I really love you. Okay,
just... Likewise.
Is this moment happening right now?
Yep.
Okay. Buckle up, we're going to church. Guys, I don't like to brag, but I did just lose 45 pounds of fat. Oh, crap. I kept off 2.7. You know, because it's hard losing weight, you know? Because when you lose weight, what they don't tell you is that it's never really lost. It's like a demon stalker waiting in the shadows for you to just have a moment of weakness. Just like, you don't really like kale salads, do you? And I don't, because I'm from Texas, okay? You don't bring us a salad unless it's rocking a deep fried tire on top of that salad.
A tire?
Can I get a witness?
Yeah!
You know, you just got to be ready because you just got to stay on the grind because what is...
Oh, my God! Look at the shoes. Look at the shoes.
I can't.
She's not. That's
yo.
Forget about you. Hold on, I'm coming for you, girl.
Oh, hell.
Listen, they never get a cheat day, girl. I didn't want to leave you out. Here you go.
Hi. Oh, she's got fries.
Come on, girl. You're so gorgeous. Howie, are we into it? You want one? Listen, you look very hydrated. I'm a little parched, baby, so...
Good evening, or afternoon, I have no idea.
Good evening, tell us your name.
I'm Jackie Fabulous.
And where are you from, Jackie?
I'm from the Bronx, I'm from Bronx, New York.
Boogie down.
Oh yeah!
And what do you do for a living?
I'm a full-time touring stand-up comic, yes.
Oh, wow.
So what got you into comedy?
You know, I went to law school, I'm a lawyer. I know, right? Total disappointment. I had to quit my lawyer job because I got fired. So it made it awkward being there every day, you know what I mean?
So when you got fired, were your parents supportive?
No.
Oh, no.
They don't understand what I'm doing. They don't get it. They don't understand who leaves being a lawyer to be a stand-up comic. They're like, why are you doing this to your life?
I don't want to wait any longer. Take it away, Jackie.
All righty. My Jamaican mother wants me to lose weight, but she doesn't know how to tell me. She's in New York, she comes to LA. You know how you see your parents, you become a child again? I'm like, oh my God, mommy! She's like, Jacqueline, Lord have mercy, you're fat. Jesus, you are fat. What are you eating, people? I don't like weight loss TV shows. If you love that show, The Biggest Loser, you and I can't be friends. You know how that show works? If somebody's overweight, you lock them on an island, and they have to work out 8 hours a day, 7 days a week, and oh yeah, we're gonna make you wear a small spandex bra and baby panties and weigh you on a scale, man, for cattle, on national TV. Wouldn't you lose weight? Who's losing these contests? You want to impress me, get a bunch of fatties and lock them in a donut shop. The first one to not go into a diabetic coma wins. That's the show I would support.
She's getting them. She's winning them over.
I don't like Facebook. It's too much work for me now. It's cool till you find that friend from too far back. You know how they find you? They're like, oh my God, I found you. What have you been doing? I'm like, last time I saw you, I learned how to read, learned how to write. Puberty was wrong. Who's this? And they send you news you don't need. Did you hear Sister Mary Ellen passed away? I'm like, when you and I were eight, she was 88. She a wizard? Is she a warlock? I hope she's dead. Should have been dead 30 years ago. And all done. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, guys.
Killed it.
Thank you.
I love you, and we want you to do well, so good luck.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Have you seen Taylor before?
I haven't, no.
He's a funny guy.
Is he?
Very funny
guy. That's his act, isn't it?
Being funny.
Yeah.
That's his act. Being funny.
I'm sorry, before I start my act, I wanted to share with you guys one of my favorite things that happened to me from being on America's Got Talent.
Is that Heidi?
And then there was that.
Heidi, if you're nice to me, maybe we can do that again sometime. We'll talk about it later. Never give up on your dreams. For real, though, you never know what's coming at you around the corner of life. Take me, for example. A few years ago, nobody knew who I was, right? Now, I make more money doing comedy than Bill Cosby.
Ha, 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 ha.
Do you get it? Laughter. I love laughter so much. It's my favorite thing in the world because it brings all of us together, you know? Like, we're way too divided right now here in this country. So many people are upset about, like, immigrants coming here, taking work away from people who are born and raised here in the USA, you know? Oh my God, you know what I just realized? The foreigners are all mad about who are taking all the jobs are the judges from America's Got Talent. Because they're from other countries. I just got back from performing in South Dakota. And I was doing a show in this little town, no diversity at all. And I went up to the promoter of the event before the show started. I was like, hey, I talk about being Jewish in my routine. I just want to make sure the audience can relate to my material. So before I do my act, I was wondering, do you guys have Jewish people here in town? And he was like, no, say whatever you want. And I was like, that's not what I meant. Oh my God. I'm really cool now. You know you're cool if you have to announce it. I'm really cool. I was at a bar talking to this girl. Things are going great. I'm really cool, you know? And I was like, we've been talking so long. I never got your name. Oh my God, what was your name? And then she was like, Sharon. And I was like, oh my God, that's my mom's name. No. No. Oh. And I was like, Sharon, we're both mature adults. We're probably some cool stuff later, if you know what I mean. You know what I mean? Just so you know, when we do that, I can't call you that because that's going to be weird for me, okay? So instead, I have to call you Mom. That joke hurts me more than it hurts you. I assure you. All right, my name is Taylor Williamson. Thank you for laughing at my jokes. I really appreciate it. Thank you
so much. Good evening. What's your name?
My name is Samuel J. Comroe. I'm a stand-up comedian.
Oh, wow. How long have you been doing that?
I've been doing comedy for 10 years now.
Do you do it full time?
Yeah, do it full time.
Okay. Are you nervous?
No, I have Tourette syndrome, so I twitch a lot. I blink real fast. My head flops around. If you see that, it's kind of cute.
It is.
Thank you.
And what does this mean to you, coming to AGT now?
This means everything. I've worked my entire life for a moment like this. They don't come very often. I'm really grateful. I just had a baby girl. And this is a beautiful opportunity.
Wow. And your family's all supportive of this career?
Yes, since I started, they've been 100% behind me, so I'm very thankful.
All right. Well, you know what? It's scary enough doing whatever you do to hit that X, and I just want the best for you. I really do.
Thanks so much.
Go ahead.
Thank you. So like I said, I have Tourette syndrome. It's why my head flops around. I blink real fast. It's weird. It always looks like I'm trying to tell you a secret. This twitch gets me in trouble. My roommate came home from work. I was like, dude, our neighbor died. He said, did you kill him? I was like, nah. Yo, this is a true story. When I was 10 years old, my parents sent me to Tourette's camp. Yeah, that's where the joke should end. It's a real place, and I didn't realize it till this moment, but I found out that when other people twitch, it makes me twitch more. So on the first day, they put us in a circle with 100 kids. Oh, no. The kid next to me did a shoulder roll. And my Tourette saw that and took that as a challenge. And I threw him a head flop. The girl next to him did a full body twitch and everybody saw that and all hell broke loose.
That is funny.
Kids were rolling on the ground. I was in the corner like, why'd they send us here? Our parents were on top of a hill like, oh, they're breakdancing. I'm Samuel J. Conroe. Thank you.
Hi. What's your name?
My name is Vicki Barbolak.
What are you going to be doing for us today?
I'm a ballerina.
Ballerina.
No. No, I can't be a ballerina because I want dinner. I'm a comedian.
You're a comedian. Okay.
You know, comedy, I think, is one of the hardest things to do because you have to entertain a whole entire room and make us all laugh.
Is that what's going on here?
Shoot. I can't wait to see this. Good luck.
All right. Thank you. Heidi, you're looking at me like you never saw a trophy wife in Los Angeles before. I'm sorry. I gotta say, yesterday I had a lot of nervous energy and I decided I'd go out to Donnelly Men's Prison for a conjugal visit. And it was like raining, 3 drops of rain. You know, in San Diego, that's like a blizzard. So it took like 3 hours to get out to Donnelly for the conjugal visit. And I'm not kidding you. I drive all the way out there and it turns out at Donnelly, you have to know somebody. Is that horrible? It's ridiculous. I hated that. Some things just don't make sense to me, like that Elon Musk guy. He could put a rocket up in the sky, you know, and it comes back down to Earth, lands on a paper cup, right? But nobody, nobody can design a bra that doesn't feel like recycled shrapnel. What's up? Right, Heidi, get on that.
I can.
Please. I'm gonna try one of yours. I need a bra, it's necessary, right? I take my bra off, my boobs fall down like a broken mini blind. I'm sort of dragging. I mean it. This is all being taken care of. This is all, I'm in therapy. We're good. You know, it's like a status symbol today. Like, I'm in therapy. I have really good insurance. There's actually a court order for me, okay? So I'm not lying. And you have to be really careful with therapists, like it's their only job to find things wrong with you, right? This woman, she's like, so, Vicki, do you ever drink alone? No way, only alcoholics drink alone, right? I read all those pamphlets in your office, man. No, I always wait till the kids get home from school, right? Yeah. Thank you, guys. Thank you.
Welcome to America's Got Talent.
Thank you. I'm excited to be here.
What's your name and how old are you?
My name is Harrison Greenbaum. I'm 30 years old.
What is it you're going to be doing for us today?
I'm a stand-up comedian. Yes.
So how long have you been doing stand-up comedy?
Well, I've been doing about 600-700 shows a year every year for the last 12 years.
That's wow. More than what you do.
Way more than me.
3 or 4 a night every night in New York.
You do all those gigs 10, 12 years.
Yeah.
So what is the tipping point that takes you from doing that into wherever the next level is you want to be?
I mean, hopefully this, right? I mean, I'm doing shows in pizzerias and basements and having beer bottles thrown on my head. So this is very nice. I mean, I've been putting the work in, but this is the big moment. This is the make or break for sure.
The stage is yours, Harrison.
Thank you. Yeah, so I decided to be a comedian senior year of college. That's when I had to tell my parents who were paying for college. Like, I had to sit them down. I was like, Mom, Dad, I have something very difficult to tell you. And they were like, you're gay. I was like, no, I want to be a comedian. And they were like, we'd rather you be gay. Like, is that still an option on the table? Because we'll go to the parade. We will go. I get it. People think I'm gay because every single thing about me. It's weird when you're not gay, but people think you're gay. People will argue with you about you, right? Like, you know what I'm talking about. Like, right? Same boat, right? They don't do that with their other preferences. I've never been at a deli. They're just like, hey, do you want cucumber? I'm like, nah. They're like, you want cucumber. You look and sound like you love cucumber. No, I don't. We're gonna put it on your sandwich. You're lying to yourself. All right, that's it for me. Thank you so much, everybody. Thank you.
I don't need to stop.
I love it.
Hello.
How you doing?
What's your name, please?
My name is Preacher Lawson.
I love that. And how old are you?
I'm 25. I'll turn 26 in 2 hours.
He's young enough to be with me.
Are you single, married?
I have a girlfriend.
You have a girlfriend?
She's dope. Yeah.
And what do you do for a living?
I'm a stand-up comedian, which means I'm unemployed and I do stand-up on the side.
All right, best of luck.
All right. I got a motorcycle. I don't like telling people I have a motorcycle, because every time I tell someone, they always got to tell me a story about how their friends crashed on a motorcycle. You know, like, why do people have to be so negative? I don't go up to pregnant women telling them my dad left. You know what I'm saying? So annoying. So annoying. I walked at my apartment one time, right? I walked at my apartment, and my neighbor walked up to me. She was like, oh, my God, you got a motorcycle? Are you serious? Are you serious? You better be careful. I got in a car wreck the other day. My car flipped 8 times. I'm lucky to be alive. Blessed, right? Yeah. She black, by the way. Everyone around us was like, you know, that is crazy that your car flipped 8 times. You're alive. You are blessed, you know? And I'm over here thinking, who the heck counted, right? Like, who's that calm when their car's flipping in the air? Ah! One! Like, who's doing that? My name is Preacher. Thank you so much. I appreciate it.
That's it.
Preacher, can I have just one more joke?
All right. I don't feel safe driving with my grandma because she's really spiritual. She loved the Lord to the point where she's not afraid of dying. So I don't like that, all right? I don't like being in a car with someone that's not afraid of death, okay? Like, she got that attitude like, if I die, I'm going to heaven, so it don't matter. I'm like, it does matter because I'm in the car, okay? This is how spiritual my grandma is. If I got shot in the chest with a gun 8 times, instead of her calling the ambulance, she would get on her knees praying like, please, Lord Jesus, I get these 8 demons outside my grandbaby's chest. Let the bullets rise up and part ways from his chest like Moses did the Red Sea. Yes, Lord. Let the blessings rain down. Yes, Lord. Little John 3:16.
Mike E. Winfield.
Mikey, what is your age?
Oh, so I'm like 20s to like 30s and stuff, you know, all right.
Where are you from?
I'm originally from Baltimore. I did adequate time in Sacramento, a lot of love.
What do you do?
You know what? I tell jokes, you know?
How long you been doing this?
Over 15 years.
So do you even remember the first time you step on a stage?
Oh my gosh, do I remember? Yeah, it was a Tuesday night open mic. And I get on stage with bright lights and arms crossed, and now they're all staring at me, and I just kind of freeze. So the fact that I came back, that means there's something wrong with me.
Okay, so show us what is wrong with you.
Okay, thank you. Thank you very much, thank you. I love older moms. Like, I like it when her kids just moved out. I can set up my computer in the extra bedroom, you know? I got married to an older woman. I got a stepson. It's cool being a parent to a kid that's close to your age. I call him stepman. He drove me here. That's my step homeboy, man. And it's a weird dynamic if you see it. He's like 6'2 with chest hair. I don't have any, you know? Teenage boys can be gross. You know when they're doing inappropriate stuff on their laptop, because when you walk in on them, they'll slam it down really fast and then ask you some irrelevant question. I walk in on Stepman. He's like, who's running for Congress? I'm like, oh. Like, Stepman. I quit my job at the grocery store. Stepman's like, what are we gonna do for money, Step Mike? I'm like, hey, don't worry about it, okay? And I worked at this grocery store for a lot of hateful years. Why is it when you hate your job, they won't fire you? And now look, I worked in the worst department at the grocery store, not the meat, not produce, not the freezer. I worked in the steel department. You familiar with the steel department, right? Self-checkout lane? I got paid to watch people steal all day. And people think you stupid. Like, you know when they're gonna rob you when they're bringing up their stuff, they always gotta look back up at you. They're like, boop, boop. This one dude tried to humiliate me. Like, I knew he was gonna rob us because I'm looking at him, he's looking at me. I'm like, just steal it. But he tries to play me in front of the entire store while he's ringing his stuff up. He makes the beat noise with his mouth. He didn't even do it right. Like, you gotta act this out, go all in, raise your pitch at least. He's like, bleh. Like, the produce is not even supposed to make a sound. You're beeping unbeepable stuff. Hey, you guys, I'm Mikey Winfield. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you.
Look at these people.
Oh, they're hearing it all. Look at this.
Wow. Thank you so much.
I mean, I don't think there's anything else to say. They love you. I love you.
Thank you.
It's amazing. Your energy, your smile. I loved it.
Oh, thank you.
Howie.
Everything you say is memorable, is authentic. Your persona. You're great.
Wow, I appreciate it.
Heidi,
you are fantastic. And then there's this face.
Thank you.
Look at his face. That face is just so cute.
Why don't you mention his face?
Isn't his face so cute?
Well, you have a real star quality about you, Mike.
He does.
You really do.
Yes.
Absolutely.
We could never do this show without an audience, particularly with an act like yourself, and this audience loved you. I mean, you could tell that.
Thank you, Simon. Thank you all. I appreciate you.
And Mike, look, we always say an audition on this show, 2 minutes literally can change your life. Maybe this is one of those auditions. I've got a good feeling about you.
Thank you.
Well, we're going to start voting. Simon.
Yes.
Me, yes.
Yes!
Four yeses! Oh, yes, yes! Oh.
We did it! Appreciate you guys. Thank you.
That was so good. Yeah, we love Mikey.
Very good.
Yeah, that kid's a star.
I mean, I think he's one of my favorite comedians that I've seen in these three seasons.
I think so.
Judge, you want to impress the most.
Honestly, I'm really hoping that Heidi likes my dress.
Oh, that's it.
I picked it specifically, so we'll see.
All right. Go on out and make your dream come true right now.
Thank you so much.
Oh, thank you. Go right on out.
Hi. Good evening. How are you?
I'm totally kidding. Not about the sign language, that part is real. I'm working with an interpreter tonight. I am really hard of hearing. I perform my sets in English, but I do like to start that way because it does make heckling me an ADA violation.
Hello. What's your name?
How are you tonight?
Oh, I'm good. My name is Hayden Kristal. I'm a comedian. I'm actually a touring comic right now. But part of why I wanted to come to America's Got Talent is watching so many other comics with disabilities come here and succeed before I did, like Drew Lynch, DJ Demers years ago. When I see other people with disability on this stage and thriving, I know that they were given the tools to be able to succeed here, which is not, yeah.
Thank you so much then for being here tonight. We're ready for you.
Thank you, okay, I'm gonna start. So I dual majored in college. I studied sign language, which that felt like a freebie, right? But I also majored in zookeeping. Which seemed like a really fun thing at the time, but now I have a degree in American Sign Language and zookeeping. And Coco the Sign Language Gorilla died like 4 years ago. So what I'm saying is that comedy has to work out for me. Yeah, this has to go, guys, this has to go good. My safety net is dead, she's gone. So I know, it's very sad. So I actually, I applied to work at the Coco Foundation when I was in college, and they rejected me because I have hearing loss. But they, yes, boo, the Coco Foundation. They told me I was a liability issue because if the gorilla were to sneak up on me, I would not be able to hear it, which I can't say with any degree of certainty, but probably that seems true. So you guys seem like a nice crowd full of hearing people, so I'm just gonna toss this question out to the room. What are y'all gonna do different if a gorilla sneaks up on you?
It's true.
Yeah, thank you, I would love to know.
That makes a lot of sense.
DM me after the show. I'm just desperate to know what home field advantage y'all have with your 2 second head start. Ridiculous. Nothing. Nothing. The only thing you're going to do different than me is die scared. That's it. That's the only thing. Yeah. Thank you.
For being here tonight. I had a great time listening to you. I love that you make fun of yourself. I was laughing the whole time. Heidi, what do you think?
We have amazing comedians on the show, and I think that you would be a great addition to what we already have, so you can really battle it out with them.
Simon.
Was that a true story?
Yes.
I mean, it's brilliantly funny. So seriously, and the fact you could turn that into a funny story, which is so crazy that they would do that. To your point, what difference does it make?
You know,
I'm with you.
I've been trying to start Twitter beef with them for like 10 years. So if you guys want
listen,
to
I'll join you.
That.
I can also see this means an awful lot to you.
Yeah, it's truly a privilege and an honor to just be here. Ah. So, thank you.
I'm really happy that we met.
Thank you so much.
I think we're gonna vote now for you. Heidi, what is your vote?
I wanna see you more, so I'm gonna give you a first yes.
I'm gonna give you your second yes.
Hayden, I'm saying yes to you. And Julie, I'm also saying yes to you.
Good luck, Hayden. I think Howie would have loved her.
Yeah, she was sweet.
Hayden, talk to me. You seem very emotional. Talk to me right now. What are you feeling?
Just validation from someplace that really meant a lot to me in starting this, and to be here, it's unbelievable. And then I felt like I already won just making it to tonight, and that was,
it couldn't have been. Hello, everybody.
Nice to meet you, and what's your name?
My name is Mr. Pants.
Mr. Pant, I don't know how to say it, but your fly is open and something is poking out.
Is that your real name?
Yes.
What, Mr. Pants?
Mr. Pants, can we get the Q-tip for Simon over here? It's Mr. Pants.
Okay, Mr. Pants, tell me where you're from.
Brooklyn, New York.
What is your day job?
Well, I used to go to the office every day, but since the pandemic, I've been virtually replaced by sweatpants.
Okay. You're a comedian?
Sir, yes, sir. I'm here to dazzle you at my stand-up comedy routine.
So what's the dream, Mr. Pants?
Vegas, baby.
Okay, I'm not going to ask any more questions. Complete waste of time. Good luck.
Thank you. I'll be right back.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Pants.
Please, Terry, my father was Mr. Pants. Look, I'm going to make this brief. I only got one day left on my return policy. I inherited my father's genes. He immigrated here from a banana republic. It was very hard on me growing up. He used to call me a huge waste. You see, both of my parents wanted me to become a lawyer. Never even came close to becoming a lawyer, but I was once involved in a suit. But I've since traveled the world. Went to Spain, fell madly in love with a Spanish sundress. And we broke up and I was pantalones.
Yeah! I love him.
But I'm happily married now.
Aw.
My wife and I are poly. It's polyester. Our daughter Capri brought home a pair of sweatpants. Hey, I want to be a supportive father, but I want to see her date someone ironed with a crease. This guy looked like he'd been donated. She asked if he could spend the night. I said, in my house, you'll sleep in separate drawers. Hey guys, I'd love to tell you more jokes, but unfortunately, I left him in my other pants. Thank you so much. You've been a lovely crowd of people.
What is your name?
My name is Aiko, and I am from Japan. I live here now, and daytime I'm a translator, and I love my job because when I screw up, I'm the only person who knows about it.
So today you're coming to AGT to
yes.
do what?
I'm here to do a stand-up comedy.
You want to start already?
Sounds good to me.
Okay.
Okay. My name is Aiko. In Japanese, it means love child. So I look up the dictionary. It says illegitimate child. My last name is Tanaka. It means in the rice field. So my whole name is illegitimate child in a rice field. Oh. Nice to meet you. I love rice.
Me too.
Is this a rice crowd? Yeah. I just got the citizenship.
Yeah!
Until I got my citizenship, I never had a road rage. If somebody cut me off, I'd be like, oh, so sorry. I was driving too slow. But the day I got the citizenship, somebody cut me off. I'm like, what the heck? You can't cut me off. This is my land. That's when I realized I become true American.
Oh, that's great. He's hilarious.
Because I felt entitled.
Oh!
Before the citizenship, somebody hold the door for me. I ran really fast. I'm like, thank you so much. After the citizenship, I'm like, you hold the door, you peasant. I got sassy.
I love her.
Racist people always say immigrants should not be working. I agree. We work too much.
That's a good point.
Now, whenever I feel lazy and I take a nap, I'm like, I'm doing this for America. Thank you, that's my time.
I mean,
I was really enjoying it, and I think all of us were enjoying
Everybody
it.
Everybody was.
Thank you. Good job.
Why are you so emotional?
I struggle with insecurity, or a lot of people say I cannot do it because this is not my language. But then I had one person who really believed in me, which is my mom.
Your mom.
Last year during the pandemic, she passed away. Aww. She wanted me to go for my dream.
I love it.
How long have you been doing this?
For a few years. I perform everywhere. I perform in the prison. It's...
Well, it's important to have a captive audience, and
yes,
you
yeah,
found
yeah, yeah.
one. I think your career is about to skyrocket, young lady. Mama was right.
From jail to America's Got Talent. I also thought you were hilarious.
Thank you.
But since you have your citizenship, don't yes. get in trouble. Don't get into trouble.
No, get into trouble. Don't That's going to be your trouble. Bread and butter, I'm telling you.
But I had a lot of fun.
Simon, what did you think?
I mean, so funny, so naughty. From the minute you walked out, you got us. You know, and the best sign of a comedian's doing well, obviously, is the audience. And I really liked your reaction afterwards, because I could see how much this reaction meant to you as well. So I would like to give you your first yes.
Was she not brilliant, though?
Hilarious.
That was amazing.
Amazing.
I love this man already.
I mean, hello, hello. If you haven't done anything already, the crowd is going crazy for you.
I paid them all to do that. So that was, I got you, Venmo, okay.
What is your name?
My name is Jordan Conley.
How old are you?
I'm 29.
And where do you come from?
I'm from Garden Grove, California.
And you came here to dance?
No,
to...
I actually came here to do stand-up comedy.
Comedian.
I've been doing it for 7 years now.
Okay, yeah. And that's how you make a living.
I would like to say yes, but also, do you want your fries with more ketchup? You know what I mean? Like, does
yeah.
that make sense?
Yeah.
Okay, I just want to confirm. That's so yeah.
But that didn't discourage you because here you are.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
So what is your dream? Where do you see yourself in the future?
I have very, very big dreams. So my dream right now is all based off of Kevin Hart. Kevin Hart did a football stadium. I think
yes.
it was like 73,000 people. My goal is 73,001.
That's ambition.
Okay, so let's see what you've got.
Okay, thank you. So, I come from a very tough upbringing. Like, I have a military family. My parents met in the Marine Corps. Like, that's where my parents
wow.
met, right? Like, my dad came to me, he was like, yo, it'd be so cool if my oldest son could join the military. I was like, Dad, it'll be so cool if you adopted somebody older than me. You, I'm not that guy. I feel like if you're gonna go overseas, you need to be willing to take secrets to the grave. I'm not that guy, okay? You know what I mean? Like, if I go overseas, let's say I get captured, I become a prisoner of war. I'm telling my secrets, your secrets, and Victoria's secrets. You know what I'm saying? Like, I could be in a hostage hostage situation and this guy's trying to threaten me. He's like, what's it gonna take to get the secrets from you? I'm like, sir, a pen and paper. Just, listen, give me that, put the knives away. This is a celebration. You caught the right guy, okay? The toughest person in my family is by far my mom. She's tough. She's old school. Like, if you ever got in trouble with her, she would turn whatever situation with you into a horror movie scene, I promise you. There's one day, she says, Jordan, didn't I tell you to come downstairs and do these dishes? You better do these dishes before you get in trouble. I lost in a video game. I got angry. I snapped. I said, you ain't done nothing all day. I suggest you stay downstairs and do them dishes before you get in trouble. Out of nowhere, this is all I heard.
Who the hell you think you're talking to?
As soon as I heard that voice, all the power in my house cut off, okay? The lights cut off, these crows came out of my closet, my windows opened up, there was these two little girls in a school uniform jumping rope and singing. They were like, one, two, your mama's coming for you. I woke up a week later confused. Thank you guys.
There's something about your energy. I think you have all the future ahead of you.
Thank you so much.
You are just naturally funny because you are super, super talented.
Absolutely.
When you did the voice, you really cracked me up. This was a really, really, really good audition. I like you a lot.
You are so fast. It's crazy how you go from here to there and here to there, but like I was like following. And then we're in your house and I was there with you and it was all funny. And I'm doing the same thing to my kids when they don't behave. Guess what?
You know, there are certain people. You mentioned Kevin Hart. And one of the things that makes these people stars is there are people that come out and then they do an act. And then there are people that come out, you believe there's no separation between who that person is and this is not an act. The difference is people go, I love Kevin Hart. People are gonna say, I love Jordan Conley. It's not his act. I love him.
Roughly 4,000 yeses.
I've never seen you laugh so much.
It was so funny.
But you were really like, you were doing like this thing.
Oh, Jordan, hey, man, give me a hug, give me a hug. Oh. You look emotional.
How many a bee fell in my eye during the performance?
Welcome, welcome, welcome.
Thank you for having me.
Who are you and where are you from?
My name is Maureen Langan. I live in Manhattan, but I grew up in Lake Hiawatha, New Jersey, where there is no lake.
So what is your talent? What will you be doing for us today?
I am a stand-up comedian.
What got you into comedy?
Well, I say a gift from God, but really, It's you grow up in a big Irish Catholic family with five siblings. You're always taking the crap out of each other, and it's just part of a natural wit, I think. You'll see.
Okay, the stage is yours. Have fun.
Thank you.
And hopefully we have some fun with you.
I don't want to hate people. They make me hate them. I'm all about love. You feel that immediately with me. But I was on the airplane coming here. A woman in the seat behind me, she gets up and she starts spritzing cinnamon. I go, lady, what are you doing? She goes, well, it's natural. I go, so is my butt, but I'm not putting it in your face. I didn't want to hate her. She made me hate her. Do you see what's happening there?
Yes.
I'm a victim. I had a car accident recently. I'm all right, don't worry. Young guy, stoned out of his mind, on his cell phone, music blaring, looked a lot like you. Gets out of his car, you know, with the man bun. dude, I don't know what happened, dude. I'm like, oh, what happened is in 1999, your mother forgot her birth control. That's what happened, dude. Well, wait a minute. I didn't want to say that. He made me say it. I was a victim. I was victimized. Okay, so what, truth be told, I am at that age, post-period, pre-death. That's my age range, here it is. I don't want to be a cougar, absolutely not. I don't need some young hot guy named Chad touching my belly fat going, ooh, what's this? What's this? This is rage. Rage, covered by affordable treats and wine from Trader Joe's. That's what this is. We got going here, baby.
Yeah.
Yes. Yes. You know what I want? This is what I want. I want a guy around 86 years old, where I am the hottest thing between him and death. He can't believe he got me, because he knows he'll never get anyone better to the day he dies. And he's not looking over his shoulder for somebody younger and hotter. You know why? He has arthritis in his neck. He can't move his neck. And he sees none of my flaws. He sees no cellulite, belly fat, varicose veins. Why? Cataracts. Cataracts. And you know what? Let me tell you something. I love him. And I look into his milky white eyes. And I say, I love you! Because he's hard of hearing and I want him to know. Because I'm all about love. Thanks, you guys. I'm Maureen Langan.
Jersey, 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 Jersey.
Thank you. That means a lot, you guys. Thank you so much.
You're funny, Maureen. It's the timing. You just have this really good timing
and
your voice and how you just like bam, 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 bam. You just have the next one coming and the next one coming. I mean, I was laughing a lot. So were you. So were you.
Yeah, well, everybody was.
Were you laughing, Simon?
So funny, so fearless. That's what Simon says.
Thank you.
What about you, Sophia?
It was fascinating. Your energy, the way that you control the stage, you didn't miss one beat. You know your material.
She had like the body movement so too. Yeah.
You feel like you need to be like on a TV show, actually.
Thank you.
Yes.
You know, you have a voice where we can hear you and we can hear your rhythm and we can hear your attitude and we love it and we connect with it. I think people not only are gonna love you, they will imitate you, they'll wanna see you. You have catchphrases.
Yes.
You have everything in that arsenal that a great comedian needs. You are ready to explode.
Thank you.
I wanted to love you and I did love you.
More women.
Let's vote. I'm going to give you a first yes. You were fantastic.
Second yes.
Sophia.
I think people are going to love you. Yes. Good evening. How are you?
Hello.
I'm well. How are you?
We're great, but are you okay?
I'm hanging in there, literally. Hanging.
Did something happen to you, or you...
I was playing basketball and I tore my Achilles.
Right before coming to AGT.
Yeah, I had to. I didn't want to miss this opportunity to perform for you guys. So.
Oh. Wow.
Yeah.
What is your name?
My name is Barry Brewer.
Barry, where are you from?
I'm from the South Side of Chicago.
Yeah.
Hey.
Well, the good thing is that whatever you're gonna do, looks like you're gonna do it sitting down, no?
Yes, I was gonna do stand-up comedy, but I'm gonna do sit-down today, so.
Oh. How did you realize that you had that gift?
I'm a musician, and I grew up playing in church on the weekends, and this guy said, man, you're funny. I was playing the drums for this community choir. He said, you should do some jokes for the concert. And I said, for real? And I did a church performance, and I got a standing ovation my first time, and I've been chasing that dream ever since.
Oh, wow. Okay, Barry, good luck tonight.
Thank you so much.
Break a leg.
Thank you, I appreciate it.
I got
thank you,
you
so much.
I got you. There we go. All right.
Woo, thank you so much. Yeah, I did travel here from Chicago.
Oh my gosh, wow.
And when I traveled, I thought that, you know, I would get a little empathy because I was on crutches because I like to go on vacation and forget I'm black sometimes. Some people don't understand, it's a little stressful. But when I got on the plane, this young lady clenched onto her purse. You know how you have to stand in first class and wait to get to coach, and she clenched onto her purse like I was gonna take it, and I was offended for two reasons. First reason is I can still take it, you're not that strong, you know what I mean? Like, you ain't been in the gym like that. Your little strength ain't gonna stop my yank if I was a thief. And then second reason, where I'm gonna go? I have crutches. You think I'm gonna steal your purse and go sit in 32C? I just think everybody should love everybody, right? Like, I just really believe in that. And being a musician, man, I got to play for different churches. I grew up and I learned how to play in church, so I got to play for black church and white church. White church is a little more simple. Their Jesus is simple. The chords are simple. The pastor, he gets up, he does his message. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. Thank you, God, that whosoever believeth in him, you just have to believe, shall not perish, but have everlasting life. And church is over. That is church in white church. It's real simple to the point. Black church, I grew up, is different. You go to church on Sunday, and then when they preach, it's like serious, like, put your hands together for Jesus. He's been too good. Hey, yeah. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. Put your hands together for Jesus. Hey! I know white people be like, their Jesus is angry. Jesus is very angry. Their Jesus has been through a lot. Thank you so much. I'm very good. God bless.
People often think my disability defines my existence. They say something like, oh, you have cerebral palsy. I know another guy with cerebral palsy. You should be best friends. But they don't like it when I go up and say, oh, you're an idiot. Know someone else who's an idiot. You should be best friends. And you don't get that with any other medical conditions either. I've never heard someone say, oh, you have herpes. My brother has herpes. You should be best friends. I have cerebral palsy. CP does not affect intelligence or hearing. In fact, the most interesting symptom of cerebral palsy is how it makes other people freaking stupid. For example, people come up to me and start gesturing at me, yelling real slow like, hello, can I pet your doggy? And I'm like, oh my, are you okay? Are you having a stroke? Do you need me to call 911? Oh, you're just an idiot. I guess we don't need an ambulance for that. People always ask why I need a service dog. I don't. You got me, I'm faking it. He has two primary services. First, he gets my beer for me.
Hi, I love you!
Good boy. Now number two, fetch me a girlfriend. You're ruining my set, you jerk. Go fetch Sophia Viagra.
I'm here.
Oh no. Damn autocorrect. I meant Sofia Vergara. We're almost done. But remember, if you don't vote for me, he won't eat tonight. I'm just kidding. Of course he'll eat tonight. He's the one that makes us dinner. Okay, make funny jokes, check. Hit on Sofia, check. Brought dog out for bonus votes, check. Perfect, that's my time. Love you all.
Ahren Belisle! Heidi!
I love how you figured out your dream to become a comedian, and it's beautiful to see you up there being so happy and making all of us laugh. Thank you so much for being here.
Sophia.
Well, I think this, I love the way you look at life. I love that that's what makes you so funny, that you make fun of yourself, that you're like so like happy with yourself. And
has anyone ever called you Sophia?
No, they have called me like that before.
Viagra?
But I'm single.
Simon. No.
Well, you are naturally funny. I mean, just that. I mean, if you're a comedian, that's what it's all about. And interestingly, unlike other acts tonight, I actually wanted it to go on longer. And you know, one of my favorite bits was when the dog, even the dog's face, when he was looking at you, even the dog's funny. He was just giving you this look like, yeah, yeah, yeah. But that was good.
Bravo!
Howie, you are on your feet.
Yeah,
man.
I'm on my feet because I love this guy. I agree with Sophia. If anybody deserves to go on and voted for one of the two, it is you. Your timing is great. Your personality is great. And I've been a fan of yours since you were first here. I love when you work dirty. We can't see it here, but you're brilliant.
Now, Ahren, why should America vote for you?
Well, I'm competing with 65 hand dancers and a rock band, and I'm equipped with nothing but a phone and a thumb.
Go out there, make it happen.
I'm gonna go out there.
Let's go, go,
okay.
Go,
oh, yeah.
Go.
Oh! Well, I remember this guy before. He's always funny. I love you.
What's
I
up?
Love this guy.
How you doing?
Preacher Lawson.
Hey, what's up, Howard Mendel?
Are you happy that he picked you?
I am so, I feel like it's a golden opportunity. Well, it could have been a golden opportunity.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
I can't believe.
Actually,
I'm a comedian, Howie.
Yes.
Howie, you did know the preacher was coming on tonight, right? But you gave your golden buzzer to another act.
Yeah, in the moment, I got caught up in emotion.
To be fair, they look like me with my shirt off, so that's... Every time I've been on America's Got Talent, I've been losing, and this time I'm here to take over, okay?
That's what I want.
Show them the laugh.
All right. What's up, y'all? Good to be back on America's Got Talent. This is great, man. Changed my life. Got the tour everywhere. Got the tour. I was in England. In England! Sorry, that was weird. I'm sorry. England! I like doing that. I know. I know it's bad. I like doing it, though. England! But it's bad. But, like, you know who else does really bad impressions? English people when they do American accents. It's bad, too. They always do the same accent. I'm from America! Every time. They do that one, or they do, like, I'm American, right? Or the third one is, yo, 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 my man. I'm like, I wonder what race he is. You know, they just assume all black people in America sound like DMX for some reason. America in the building, where my dogs? I gotta pee, all right? I don't know how to transition. I'm just letting you know I gotta pee. I gotta pee. You ever have to pee like real bad? Like, you know, real bad. You had a public restroom, right? Right? And instead of it saying like men and women, they try to be creative. It's like a boat and a fish. You're like, which one? Everyone's walking to the wrong restroom. Every woman in here has walked in and been like, when they put urine on inside the restroom? And every dude has walked in like, is that a couch? They got a couch? Is that a vending machine? What kind of candy is that? That's some weird candy. They got lotion? Why they got lotion inside the restroom? Can't have a lotion in the men's restroom. Yeah, you know, because we're not going to use it. It's a waste of lotion. What are y'all laughing at? What were y'all laughing at? It's funny because women are cleaner than men until it comes to your restroom. I went into a woman's restroom, I seen pee on the toilet. Like, I expect that in a men's restroom. Fellas, how many times you walked in the restroom and you seen pee on the ground immediately? Right? Who's that guy walking in? Oh, man, I was so close. There's always some old dude peeing 3 feet from the toilet. It's like, come on, man. We all know you don't got that much horsepower. But women are funny. Women are the only people that go to the restroom in groups. You rarely see dudes. I got to pee, Brandon. Let's roll, brother. Should have said some money. Let's get out of here, man. Where's Tyler at? Tyler here? Yeah. All three of us, we can go together, you know. Hopefully they got a couch. You know, we can take selfies. That'd be awesome. That'd be nice. Is that lotion? My name is Preacher Lawson. Thank you so much. Y'all are awesome. Thank you so much. Thank you.
You got jokes. You got charisma. I don't have a golden buzzer anymore.
You don't!
But I got a feeling you're not gonna need it. I got a feeling that you're gonna be one of the six that go through today.
Thank you.
I feel like this was the funniest set ever. Not even just from you, from anyone ever.
Oh, wow.
Doing a set.
Oh, you better stop, girl. You what?
The only way you can judge this is, did we laugh more? And the answer is yes.
Yes!
That is what I would call a winning performance.
Oh!
And I really like you.
Yes, we love you.
Howie's my hype man. I appreciate that.
I love you, buddy.
I appreciate you, man. Thank you so much.
Absolutely brilliant. That was so good. You're so good.
Yeah. Look, man, I want to win it. So I did all I could do, and hopefully that's enough, and then they vote me through.